GoPro with the Saramonic mic, next thing to tackle is stability. And I don't know if you guys saw the Cars and Coffee video. See it over here. GoPro out of the box, while it has good video, doesn't have good stability control built in or in software. So I picked up a 3-axis handheld gimbal for the GoPro to get more stable shots. I can't turn it on with nothing in it. Flips the out. So what I'll do is I'll put the GoPro in it and just kind of give a quick demo of what it exactly does and show some video. All right, and now this is the GoPro on the 3-axis gimbal. You can see I can move this around quickly, slowly, pan it around. Nice stable video. Doesn't flip out on you. We'll target things randomly sometimes. There's also some modes on this that I gotta learn, and you can actually pitch it with a joystick on the back of the gimbal, which is kinda neat. And then it's got, I guess they call it selfie mode. Press the button, it spins around on you. It's gonna be a little farther out for that. Let it go, spins back. I guess for vlogging or whatever. Don't do a whole lot of that. So let's see what this actually looks like on the G8. Dug down, no more muck, except they started to get lazy towards the end. They didn't dig out this corner, and there's literally a f***ing road right there. It's all dug out, ready for the next quad inspection. Hopefully we're gonna pass this time. Especially because I just dug out that entire corner. Pulled all that out. Don't fill lakes with this crap. You know, in the last video I showed all the muck that we put out here. Kind of level this out, get the grass going again. What I didn't show is we had 13 loads here, to fill that hole. They leveled it out, compacted it. All the dirt's gone. And we are nowhere near where we need to be of 36 inches. So I need another 10 loads of dirt. I think I'm in like 30 loads at this point. Third time I said maybe 10 more loads. The amount of dirt that is sitting right here, I could have bought the cappuccino from Jack. I just want to put that out there. This is just dirt. But I think I have all the dirt I need to finally get the building going. I guess we'll find out. Needs to stop raining so we could pour some concrete, get this building going. The actual building itself is going to be delivered on July 9th, so all this needs to be filled in, not be a quasi swimming pool. Pad is officially complete. All the relief cuts have been made, everything's been set for where the doors are going to go, and this is going to be the building. Met with the builder today. Building will be here on the 9th, and then they can get started. Definitely seems a lot bigger, you know, walking on this thing versus just looking at it when it was just dirt. So, still not too sure how I want to lay everything out. I do know I want to get at least two lifts in here, maybe a double stack. To store some cars on. There should be plenty of room to get some work done. The bulk of the building is assembled. Obviously, we have no roof yet. But we will soon. Framed in, doors are in, all the wall insulation is in. So basically, what I think is going to happen, so there's going to be a four-post four-car rack here for storage. We're gonna have a two-post rotary lift 10K here, and another one probably about here. Area for working on stuff back there, and then about halfway where this pillar is over, it's gonna be framed in and AC'd for storage and computers and stuff like that. And the rest of the area with the 4 foot on the wall on both sides is going to be pallet racks for more storage. So I think we're going to have sufficient enough room to get some work done in here. Only delay that we're going to have is doors. So I have a large pallet out here with two 10x10 doors. There's your problem. I ordered two 10x10 insulated doors. These are two 10x10 non-insulated doors. So now, I have to come all the way back here, pick this pallet up, put it on a truck, and then get me some more doors. No idea when they're going to do that. Still haven't heard back from them. But hopefully next week or two, so I'll be all together and I can start moving stuff into it.